I simply cannot remember a time when Sally Field wasn't on television or in the movies. Over the course of my 50 plus years living on this big blue ball, one of the constants has been this talented lady. Whether it was reruns of Gidget or The Flying Nun, as a kid, I thought that the characters that Sally played were tons of fun. In those early television programs, Sally seemed to be smiling all of the time, and you know what? That made me smile too. And then there was this epic miniseries during the mid-70s starring Field and Joanne Woodward. I think this particular television event may have been the very first time that I became aware of multiple personality disorder. And truthfully, it was so odd to see the actress who played Gidget in this role. But you know what? She pulled it off. I think Sybil was the moment when the entertainment industry realized that Sally was so much more than just a pretty face. She was a major acting talent. And whatever role she took, she really did elevate it. I'm just going to highlight a few of my favorites. I'm leaving out a ton here. But that's okay because this video is not meant to be a filmography. That said, man, I love those Smokey and the Bandit movies. Burt Reynolds, Jackie Gleason, Jerry Reed, and Dom DeLuise. Yep, they were all great, but Sally, like I said earlier, well, she had a way of making anything that she was in better. Fast forward a few decades, and that certainly was the case for her relatively thankless turn in the two Andrew Garfield Spider-Man flicks. They certainly could have given her more to do in those films, which, by the way, for the record, I liked the first one, but really didn't enjoy number two at all, where Sally's Aunt May was even more underutilized. Truly a mess of a film, if you ask me. Anyway, with all this said, let's get to the point of the video we're watching right here, which is that there was a moment, a truly tender moment in Sally's life, which changed everything for her. It was a moment early on when a young teenage Sally Field wasn't sure that acting was her destiny. Can you imagine this Oscar-winning actress thinking that? Well, I guess it's not all that hard, because when you're young and still trying to figure things out, well, the Academy Awards can seem a million miles away. Sally shared that monumental, pivotal moment with reporters after winning her Best Actress Award for the 1979 motion picture, Norma Rae. During that interview, Sally reflected back to those early teenage years, and in particular, a moment when she was with her mother after having performed a scene in a junior high school play. If I remember correctly, she said it was Romeo and Juliet. And Sally, well, she wasn't happy with her performance, so much so that she was truly questioning her desire to be an actress. According to Sally, by all accounts, it hadn't been a good performance. In fact, Sally herself described the performance as, and I quote, horrible. But way back then, after the play, Sally's mom looked at her daughter with love, pride, and unfaltering faith and simply said, "Sal, you've got magic." And that was it. Her mother's belief in her was enough to sustain her and buoy her up and allow her to move forward with conviction. It allowed her to believe in herself. Sally said that her mother had always given her strength in her times of need. And truly, there is something that is to be said for the power of a parent's love. Their love, or lack thereof, can have a huge impact. It certainly did in Sally's case. Without that moment, it's quite possible that there would have been a different actress portraying Norma Rae. Or even worse, if you ask me, Gidget or the Flying Nun. Alright, now it's your turn. Please let me know what you think and share your memories in the comment section. And while you're at it, I'd love a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. And I would be absolutely honored if you would consider subscribing to my channel. I talk about music, movies, and mostly television from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.